हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द कोऑपरेटिव बाइंडिंग इन हीमोग्लोबिन। इन हीमोग्लोबिन अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ बाइंडिंग इज फाउंड फॉर ऑक्सीजन, दैट इज कॉल्ड द कोऑपरेटिव बाइंडिंग। इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस टाइप ऑफ बाइंडिंग, वी विल फर्स्टली कम टू दीज टू प्रोटीन्स दैट आर फाउंड इन द ह्यूमंस, दैट आर हीमोग्लोबिन एंड मायोग्लोबिन, दैट एक्ट एज अ ऑक्सीजन कैरियर इन द ह्यूमंस। हीमोग्लोबिन इज फाउंड इन ब्लड वाइल द मायोग्लोबिन इज फाउंड इन द टिश्यूज। अबाउट इट्स स्ट्रक्चर, वी हैव स्टडीड इट्स स्ट्रक्चर इन अवर अर्लियर वीडियोज। यू कैन सी दैट वीडियोज इफ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब्ड अवर चैनल। प्लीज सब्सक्राइब द चैनल सो दैट यू कैन गेट मोर एंड मोर वीडियोज। सो इन शॉर्ट, हीमोग्लोबिन इज अ टेट्रामर, इट मीन्स इट पजेस फोर सब यूनिट्स एंड इट्स सब यूनिट्स वर्क्स इंडिपेंडेंटली, नॉट इंटरडिपेंडेंटली। While in myoglobin, it is a monomer and it possesses one unit. It means it possesses one heme group and a protein chain wrapped around it. Hemoglobin can bind four oxygen molecules, while myoglobin can bind only one oxygen molecule. Hemoglobin works in lungs where oxygen's partial pressure is very high. Where it joins oxygen, it binds oxygen four molecule and forms oxyhemoglobin. That is denoted by HbO2 का होल फोर। इन टिश्यूज मायोग्लोबिन वर्क्स एंड इट एब्स्ट्रैक्ट द ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द ऑक्सी हीमोग्लोबिन एंड इट फॉर्म्स ऑक्सी मायोग्लोबिन। इट कैन बाइंड ओनली वन ऑक्सीजन मॉलिक्यूल, सो वी कैन सी दैट द ऑक्सीजन एफिनिटी ऑफ द मायोग्लोबिन शुड बी ग्रेटर देन दैट ऑफ द हीमोग्लोबिन। इन हीमोग्लोबिन अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ बाइंडिंग इज फाउंड, that is cooperative binding. It means its all subunits works interdependently. It means the affinity of one, the binding of one unit increases the affinity of other units. In order to understand the cooperative binding, we will understand this oxygen binding curve. In this curve, we have plotted the partial pressure of oxygen at the x-axis, while at y-axis, we have plotted the percentage saturation of hemoglobin or myoglobin. So, we get the curve of this type. In this curve, there are two lines, one at this. This shows the partial pressure of oxygen in the muscles, and this is the line. This shows the partial pressure of oxygen in the lungs, which is 100 mm. That is higher than that in the muscles. So this red curve is for the myoglobin. This is a normal curve. It means its value increases, the affinity of myoglobin for oxygen increases with increasing the partial pressure of oxygen, and the value of oxygen increases, and this curve also the saturation of myoglobin also increases, and after some time we get a saturated oxymyoglobin. And this black curve is for hemoglobin. It is a sigmoid curve. It means at initial it increases very slowly, and then there is a rapid increase, and then there is a saturation. This type of curve is known as the sigmoid curve. From this curve we can see that when one oxygen molecule is bound to hemoglobin, this is bound very slowly, but when this is bound, the other oxygen molecules are bound very rapidly. This type of curve is shown by the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin has another specificity. It means it also shows the pH dependence. It means the decreasing value of pH. It means when the value of pH decreases, the affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen also decreases. This is the curve for hemoglobin at lower pH. This lower pH when occurs, when there is accumulation of carbon dioxide in the blood. As a result of this, the pH of blood slightly decreases. It decreases slightly because blood is a buffer solution. And as a result of this accumulation, the affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen also decreases. This effect is known as the Bohr effect. So you have seen this cooperative binding curve. Now from this curve we can get the following conclusions. The first conclusion that we get from this curve about hemoglobin is that at lower pressure of oxygen, less oxygen is bound. It happens in tissues where hemoglobin is transfers its oxygen to the myoglobin. The second point, when higher pressure is of oxygen, it means at higher pressure of oxygen, more oxygen is bound to hemoglobin. This happens in lungs where hemoglobin binds more and more oxygen. So binding of oxygen to one unit of hemoglobin increases the binding affinity of other units for oxygen. This type of binding is called the cooperative binding. The next conclusion that we get from this curve is that the oxygen affinity decreases by decreasing the pH. This is due to the accumulation of carbon dioxide in the muscles. So what happens? The hemoglobin releases the oxygen and binds one proton for every 2 moles of oxygen release. It means when 2 molecules of oxygen are released, one proton is bound by the hemoglobin. What is the function of this proton? Actually, this proton can form the bicarbonate ion with the carbon dioxide, and it provides a route for the transportation of carbon dioxide to the lungs. Now we come to the cooperativity. What is the molecular basis of this cooperativity? Actually, hemoglobin has 2 conformations. It means it can gain 2 conformations. One is T or tensed form. That is found in deoxyhemoglobin when hemoglobin has not bind the oxygen. This form has low affinity for oxygen. The another conformation is R or relaxed conformation. That is found in oxyhemoglobin. It means when hemoglobin has bind oxygen. This conformation has high affinity for the oxygen. So what is this? In deoxy state, actually iron is in +2 oxidation state. In this state, iron has the 6 electrons and 4 in the T2g state and the 2 in the Eg level. So this iron will have larger radius and it remains above the plane of the porphyrin ring. The 4 subunit interacts in this way that the proximal histidine residue is strained to resist this iron above the plane of the porphyrin ring so that it cannot come in the plane of the ring. This state will have strain, so it is called T state or tensed state. Now when oxygen come in contact, it is bound to oxygen. Oxygen is a strong field again and it turns the iron from +2 to +3 oxidation state. This state will have 5 electrons and these electrons are paired in the T2g state and the Eg state will be empty. So the radius of the iron becomes smaller and it moves within the plane of the porphyrin ring. And this iron also pulls the proximal histidine towards the plane. This state is known as the relaxed state or R state. And this movement is transmitted to the other binding sites so that their conformation is changed in such a way that all units binds the oxygen more rapidly. So the binding at one site increases the affinity or the binding power of other units increases, and this increases the binding affinity of other units. Such type of binding is called the cooperative binding. This type of binding is found in the hemoglobin. So this is about the cooperative binding in hemoglobin.